Was a violent criminal like Michael Klunder ever released from prison? Patrick Bell is here with those answers tonight.
Yeah, Stacey, a complex question with a very simple answer. And for one Central Iowa mother, it's the law that has got to change.
Pleaded guilty to kidnapping two children, and he was convicted of kidnapping a 19-year-old woman.
Why didn't he get life in prison? Why did he get back out after two kidnappings? On his record.
Noreen Gosh is angry, and with good reason. After all, her son was abducted more than 30 years ago. She says Michael Klunder never should have been released.
Had somebody enforced the law, given him the punishment that is supposed to be for kidnapping, he wouldn't have been out on the street.
But Klunder's crimes, according to the Iowa Department of Corrections, never qualified for mandatory sentencing. In other words, he never had to serve a certain amount of time in prison. So in 1992, when a judge sentenced him to 41 years behind bars, his term began to shrink.
When someone walks in our door, if they don't have a mandatory sentence, which in this case did not, for every day they serve, 1.2 days comes off the back end, and eventually they meet, and that becomes the discharge date.
Well, you know, they get life in Iowa, and life is life. Well, apparently not. So I think maybe some of the legislators would be happy to come forward and give us the reasons why the law works for some people, and then others are let off, and they're dangerous criminals.
And Michael Klunder was also classified as a Tier 2 sex offender by the state of Iowa. That means he was required, Stacey, to report to the Hamilton County Sheriff's Office 2 times a year.
Well, do we know if he did report in 2013?
Yeah, according to court records, he did in January. And as Emily Price reported just a few moments ago, because his original victim was an adult, that meant Klunder had no restrictions in regards where he could live. He could live anywhere.
All right, Patrick, thank you.